and a prophecy.
Yes.
Okay? So what I'm asking you is this, yeah, is you said that soothsayers are able to tell what's going to happen 400 to 500
And you have to explain
give
their...
No, give us an example of a soothsayer
I am.
In the Bible.
But are you not right. listening to what I'm trying to... No, are you not listening to me? I'm asking...
You know,
before I give you an example, before I give you an example, you have to understand what we're talking about, right? Do you have to explain a problem? When you say Jesus, his crucifixion was foretold in the book of Isaiah chapter 53, suffering servant. Suffering servant in the book of Isaiah.
There's many prophecies
yeah,
about Jesus.
Yeah, I'm talking about the crucifixion. It's foretold in the book of Isaiah 53, right?
Okay.
Yes? And it doesn't say Jesus, a man called Jesus, will be put on the cross in the year.
It doesn't say that.
So you have to explain. You have to expand on the prophecy. You have to interpret the prophecy, the words of God, to explain, to make sense of the prophecy.
Really,
right?
Not really. Let me tell
but
you
But is it explicit?
Let me tell
Go
you
and read the passage.
Okay, let's
is
read.
It clear?
Yes. Let's read.
Is it explicit?
No. Let's read.
Does it say the date,
okay.
the name, the
no,
cross?
Let's read
the
it.
People
let's
who crucified.
Stop. Are you talking to everyone? Are you talking to
me? No, I'm talking to you.
Okay, let's read Isaiah 53. Let's look at prophecy. We haven't even got to Muhammad, but we'll stick to the Bible.
We'll go to Muhammad.
No,
we're not going anywhere. Plenty of time.
You don't want to talk about
Muhammad. Plenty of time.
Let's talk about.
No, we'll talk about Muhammad. We'll talk about Muhammad. I want to talk about Muhammad. I love him.
But you don't want to talk to him. The first question I asked you was about Muhammad.
Listen,
you still haven't.
Listen,
we spoke about David.
You see,
we spoke about Saul. Okay. So let's
at least we all learned one lesson today. That lesson is when you ask someone the question, understand the question yourself before you ask it to someone. Right? You need to know your terms before you. So when you ask someone, who are you? You are a good man. Are you a good man? So understand what you mean by good. The question can ask, the person can ask you, what do you mean by good? And then you can give your definition of good.
Yeah.
Okay? And then that person can dissect your definition as well. So this is what we're doing right now. We need to get the definitions right before we move on to Muhammad.
Now he's showing
and once we get the definitions right, everything will fall into
place.
Isaiah 53, show me. Show me in Isaiah 53 that a man called Jesus will be crucified by the Romans.
It doesn't say that.
It doesn't say that.
Thank you.
It
doesn't say that. So how do you link that prophecy to the crucifixion? How do you do that?
So let me read it and then we'll see.
It's called hermeneutics. It's called hermeneutics. That's what it's called. I'm sure you don't know what hermeneutics is.
I don't know what hermeneutics is.
Do you know what it is?
Yes, I do.
So that's what we apply, right?
Okay, right. So what we're going to do is that, okay.
You're reading something I already know. I already I made the point. So I'm asking.
Wait, one second.
Are you gonna,
one second, Abraham, because you're talking a lot.
Yeah.
Right. So, okay, you said that there's no way.
I'm not saying that.
Wait.
I'm not saying anything.
You're saying that because you're saying you have to use hermeneutics, you have to use exegesis. You're saying that
Thank
we have
you.
Right. So what I'm saying to you is this:
Am I wrong or right?
Us as Christians,
yeah.
Okay, anybody who reads this, for me, it'll be clear. Let me read the reason why I think it'll be clear. Before, because you don't want to talk about Muhammad.
I'm a disbeliever.
Hold on, for example.
You're saying there's a prophecy in the Bible about Jesus.
I know. Okay,
and I come to you as a disbeliever. I say, okay, hold on a second. You're claiming there's something in the Bible.
Yeah.
So I'll ask you to explain it to me. And then you will go to the book of Isaiah. You're not going to show me a man called Jesus was put on the cross by the Romans.
Yeah.
In the first century,
what time?
in a province
day,
called Judea.
Day,
you're not going to show me that. It doesn't exist.
So, what are you talking?
Just to help you out.
Let's make it simple, man. Let's make it simple. Let's not complicate. Don't fight a battle you cannot win. So the point is, we both agree. We have to apply.
We're not agreeing, you're not letting me read. You don't want to ask about Muhammad.
Okay.
Then I say, okay, you don't want to talk about Muhammad. So let's talk about Isaiah.
You
don't want to talk about Isaiah.
You obviously don't understand.
You obviously don't understand what
a logical discussion is.
Well, I'm asking,
we're trying to.
You said you've used Isaiah as an example, so let me read Isaiah. Let me read what your example is.
Okay, read. Show me where Jesus was crucified.
Okay. And it's clear.
Does it say Jesus is. We're going to speak this clear. Okay.
Okay, before you read that,
the guy that won't be. I'm going to read it.
Read it. I'll listen to it. No problem.
Okay. Who has believed our message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a tender shoot and like a root out of parched ground. He has no stately form of majesty, but he should look upon him, no appearance that he should be attracted to him. He was despised and forsaken, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And like one from whom men hide their face, he was despised, and he did not esteem him. Surely our griefs he himself bore, our sorrows he carried. Yeah? Yet we ourselves esteemed him stricken, smitten of God, afflicted, but he was pierced for our transgressions. Specific.
specific.
He was crushed for our iniquities.
Specific to who? You said specific. You just use the word specific. Specific to who?
He was pierced for our transgressions.
Specific to who?
He was crushed for our iniquities. The chastisement of our well-being fell upon him. And by his scourging, we were healed. All of us, like trees, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own
way. Okay, so you read a lot.
The Lord has caused iniquity of us all to fall on him. Now,
okay.
The reason why this is so specific, yeah?
It's so specific that it says Jesus was crucified.
Hold on. The reason why it's specific, because he was pierced for transgression. There's no other prophet that's prophesied to be pierced. Give me an example of someone who was pierced.
Very good. No. Very good. I understand. I'm trying to help you.
Let me finish.
Okay. You're going to dig a deeper hole for yourself before you're I'm trying to save you embarrassment.
Okay. So, give an example of someone who was pierced for our transgression.
Good. Can I give an example? Can I respond? Okay, you finish. You're going deeper and deeper into the hole.
The chastisement of our well-being fell upon him. Yes. Okay, he was chastised. He was scourged. He was whipped. Okay.
And what the point is? The point.
So I'm saying that only Jesus Christ was prophesied to be pierced
for
our sins.
Very good.
Can you show me another?
You did exegesis. You did exegesis. Yeah. You indulged in. Let me finish. You indulged in hermeneutics. You read a text and then you said, "Tell me who else was pierced like that." So you're trying to link.
Was it clear?
It's not. Hold on a second.
This is not clear.
It's not clear. No.
So our prophet was pierced.
I'll tell you what.
Our prophet was pierced.
Yes. I'll tell you what.
Okay. Let me explain.
Have you read the Jewish commentaries on this passage? Have you?
Jewish? No.
Yeah. So you don't know, right? who was pierced or not, right? You don't know, right?
Jewish rabbis.
Okay. I recommend a book for you, Christopher North. He has written a commentary on Deutero-Isaiah, this part of Isaiah in particular. And the book is called The Suffering Servant in Deutero-Isaiah. It's very specific. It deals with this very issue. Go and read the book and then your mind will be blown away. The amount of interpretations, the amount of different meanings of this particular passage are to be found in Christian as well as Jewish literature. So you are one track minded. You know, you can't see anything else. You can only see Jesus. And even for that, you have to explain. You had to explain that this is Jesus. Now, I was trying to save this 15 minutes you wasted on this.
I was saying to you.
Okay.
I was saying to you.
Okay.
But there's only.
So you just wasted time.
No.
You wasted 10 minutes.
Okay. Let's go back to what we're saying. Hold on. We're saying, what's the difference between prediction and prophecy? And I'm saying prophecy is so specific.
It's not specific.
Right. Now, you it's can, not specific. Can you show me how this is not specific?
Because it doesn't. You're saying it talks about Jesus.
I'm saying that only Jesus was pierced for our sins.
Okay, so you're now explaining.
For our sins.
So you are.
Who says it then? Are you pierced for our sins?
Are you? Is there an inference here or not? Are you inferring?
Adnan.
Are you inferring?
Adnan, it's just basic, clear English. Was Jesus, according to Christians, you speak to many Christians.
Exactly, it's basic, clear English. Are you inferring? Are you inferring? If the text said Jesus, a man called Jesus, the son of Mary, will be pierced and crucified by the Romans in the first century in the city called Jerusalem, and Pontius Pilate will be the man responsible for announcing the death sentence on him. If I read that, no debate, no questions. I wouldn't be discussing it. The fact that all of this is not there, you are saying it is Jesus, and I'm saying you are inferring. You are inferring. You're saying this refers to Jesus. You're making that claim.
Jesus? I heard what you said. You're saying that because it didn't have specifics, days, times, everything else.
Yes.
What I'm saying to you, what makes it so specific is if it claims exclusivity.
Okay.
For example, there's certain things.
You never finish it.
There's certain things that we can only attribute to God. For example.
Very good point.
Hold on.
Let's assume.
No. Let me finish.
I'll let you finish.
There's certain things we can probably.
Everyone, listen to him carefully. Listen.
There's certain things we can only attribute to a certain particular person, like perhaps to yourself or to God. So attributes that he has, that he's all knowing.
So specific. You're saying specific.
So what I'm saying to you is that here is saying that this man was pierced for the sins of mankind.
Very good.
According to Christians, who was pierced for the sins of mankind,
very
for
good.
Our transgressions?
Very good.
Who was that?
Okay.
Are you going
to
answer that?
I'm coming back to that.
No, don't come back. Answer that. Because yes. You wouldn't ask about Muhammad.
According
now
to Paul.
Now we're going to the Bible.
Yeah, I'm answering the question, man.
Okay, answer that.
Yes.
Answer that.
Yeah. According to Paul, it was Jesus, yes. According to Paul, it was Jesus.
Okay,
yes.
So according to the Bible.
According to Paul. According and to I believe Paul was a liar.
Okay.
I believe.
Right.
Okay.
So we've agreed that in the Bible, it says that it was Jesus Christ.
Yes, Paul.
That was pierced for.
Paul.
In the Bible.
No.
It's put in the Bible.
In the New Testament, Paul says it's Jesus.
Right.
Yes.
In the New Testament, the Bible.
Yes.
Why is it so hard to say New Testament, the Bible?
Because
yes,
it's in the Bible.
Okay. Yeah, in the Bible.
So we agree.
In the Bible.
So we agree.
We agree in the Bible.
Okay.
Yes.
So we have a prophecy and it's specific to only one person.
Right. Now, very good.
Okay. Right. So now let's go back to the question. Day dot one.
Okay.
What makes Muhammad a prophet? You haven't answered that. You have not answered.
Have you explained? Have you explained?
You answer.
Wait. Let me finish.
I listened to you.
Can you listen to me now? Okay.
You said.
Wait. No problem. Don't worry.
You answer.
We all breathe.
Answer the question. Answer the question. What makes Muhammad a prophet?
Answer the question. It's not going to help you.
How long will I ask the question for? Ask the question.
Can I respond?
What makes Muhammad?
Can I respond?
Yes.
Can I respond?
Yes.
Using your criteria, that particular prophecy is specific. He's claiming it's specific. I'm saying it's not. And I'm sure he does not understand.
I'm trying to answer the question about Muhammad.
If you want to walk away, you can walk away.
I will walk away if you don't come answer.
Okay, if you can't have a discussion.
I don't mind.
Why are you struggling?
No, because
are you struggling?
I showed you.
But you don't let me finish.
No. You're going off track.
No, I'm not. I'm sticking to the topic.
No.
This is the topic.
No.
Prophecy. Prophecy is the topic we're discussing.
Yes.
Prophecy. Prophecy is the topic we're discussing.
Go back to what
I'm going back to the prophecy.
Why do you like to talk about Muhammad? Why do Muslims struggle to talk about Muhammad?
I love Muhammad.
I've delivered lectures. I've gone to Isaiah 53. I've gone throughout the scripture. But yeah, you're free to go to your Quran.
Free your mind.
Why can you not talk about Muhammad?
Can you remain silent?
Why can you not talk about Muhammad?
Can you remain silent for 1 minute?
No, I can't remain silent.
Am I going to talk?
Because you're not responding.
I'm responding.
But you're talking about the Bible.
You don't like my response.
No. Because you're changing the subject.
Okay.
So the question specifically.
The question is, what makes Muhammad a prophet?
Yes, I want the
answer. And I am asking, what is a prophet?
So you're going to answer
and we're still discussing that.
It's the same thing.
So what is a prophet?
It's the same thing.
What is a prophet?
No.
What
I've
is
answered
a prophet?
You over and over again.
You have not answered
I've answered you over and over again.
Can we time them?
Okay. So what I'm saying to you is this, right? What I'm saying to you is this, yeah?
Can we time them?
Initially, ask you the question. This is summary.
Carry on. You can repeat it 10 times.
But I've asked you the question. I've said, what makes Muhammad a prophet?
And I asked, what do you mean by prophet?
Let me respond. You've said, I know what you said. You said to me, okay, it's a fair question. You've said to me, okay, what makes a prophet? Okay, you need to clarify the standard, the terms. And I said, okay, fair enough. All right. So I said, if a prophet comes with prophecies or miracles, he said, okay, now you have to be even more specific. Show me.
You and I have a discussion.
Show me.
Be fair.
Stop.
Believe me, you know my answer. You know my
to
answer.
To be fair. Okay.
Yeah. So then I asked.
I'm clarifying. I'm not.
Right.
I'm not saying nothing wrong.
Okay. Sure.
So then you've been more clear. You've said, be more specific. Wait, you said be more specific. You said what do miracles, define miracles and prophecies. It's not, you didn't just want me to say miracles and prophecies, you said define it. I've been defined according to me, and I even used texts like Acts 2 and also Deuteronomy 18 to say this is what, according to what a prophecy is.
And I explained how do you get to a prophecy, how do you explain?
And then you said, and then the miracles, I not only explained it to you, but also gave you examples of miracles. For example, raising people from the dead, healing blind, and so on and so forth. Okay, and I've said to you, right, I've given you scriptures, I've given you explanations, I've given you hermeneutics, exegesis.
Yeah,
then you've gone over to David.
Me away with all the
then you've gone over to David, okay, and you said, all right, David falls into the category of prophecy, prophets. I said, okay, I agree with you. Okay,
no,
I
was wrong. Wrong.
I was wrong, and I admitted, and I put my hands up. Yeah. Okay, I was wrong. Okay, God is wrong.
No, no, we're
flashing
not.
Lights.
We're not celebrating.
Okay. So yeah, but
we're fine with that. No problem.
No. So what I'm saying to you, fair. Okay, so. Okay, David falls in the category, yeah? Right, you said you can prove miracles, you can prove prophecies. Yes, fantastic, you can prove it with David, but why can you not prove it with Muhammad?
10 seconds.
Why can you not prove it with Muhammad? Prove it with David, prove it with Moses, prove it with Jesus, prove it with Muhammad.
Stop. If,
right, stop. I want you to prove it with
Muhammad. My time now, you can't interrupt me.
I won't.
You cannot interrupt me.
I won't interrupt you.
You cannot interrupt me.
Stick to the subject.
No.
I'm going to walk off.
If you don't answer, you don't interrupt.
It's my time. It's my time. Yeah, you have to be patient. Okay. Okay. Now, Godwin said that that prophecy in Isaiah 53 specifically. And then he had to explain why specific. Even to explain why specific, he had to explain it, right? So we do the same standard. Now we apply the same standard Godwin applied on Jesus and that prophecy. In the book of Isaiah, same book, chapter 29, verse 12, we have a verse. It states, when the book is given to the one who is not learned, and it is said to him, read, he will say, I am not learned. And when the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was in the cave of Hira, he received a man, an angel in the shape of man, and he came and he said, Iqra, read. And Muhammad said, Ma ana biqari'in, I am not learned. This is what you call specific. Okay? Now watch him reject this prophecy and say, no, this is not Muhammad. And amazingly, this incident never happened anywhere else in the entire history of humanity. No other man can be thought of when we discuss this prophecy. So even though Isaiah 53 is vague, he thinks it's specific. And even though this one I just quoted from Isaiah 29:12 is specific, he will say it doesn't apply to Muhammad. It is something else. Okay, so it is very clear that these people are completely inconsistent when it comes to their standard of prophethood. They apply one standard to Jesus, and when it comes to Muhammad, they completely divorce all those standards. They throw them in the sea. They don't want to talk about them. That's why I'm trying to dissect his definitions. I'm trying to understand what does he mean by prophecy, and what is the difference between prediction and prophecy. It's a very important question. Before we start talking about prophethood, we need to understand what it constitutes, and what it constitutes. According to Godwin, it constitutes two things. One is prophecy, the other one is miracle. And we're trying to understand what is a miracle and a prophecy. And he simply cannot explain what these two things are, because he's still struggling.
Stop.
Okay, my time is up. Thank you for being silent.
So that's fine.
2 minutes.
Can we
3 minutes?
No, 2 minutes.
So
I want us to dialogue.
The prophecy.
Because I've got questions for
him. No. Otherwise, we're not going to get a word.
No. You go your turn.
This is better.
Okay, I want to know, you just said a prophecy of Muhammad.
Yes.
I want to know where that prophecy is. I want to read it. Okay, so we can dissect it.
Yeah, read it. There.
No. You got this in Isaiah.
29:12. Same book.
Read it.
Okay, let's read this.
It's out of your time, by the way.
What verse?
12. I stopped the time, yeah?
And if it is given to those who cannot read, saying, read this, they say we cannot read. That's what you just said, yeah?
Yeah.
You're in big trouble.
No,
hold on, let's look at the context.
No, I'm not a...
Let's look at the context, okay?
I'm going to remain silent.
Hold on, let's look at the context. So you can
read from verse 10.
Okay, so
read from verse 10.
I'm going to read.
No, if you want to read the context, read.
I did not cut you off. Why can't you give me the same respect?
Time is stopped.
So let me read this.
You want the context? Read from verse 10.
Let me read what I want to read. You spoke.
You got free time.
But you said context.
Let me read. Don't cut. You're free. You're fearful.
No, I'm not. Read.
Okay, read.
I'm fearing.
You've just said that this has to be Muhammad, and if it is given to those who cannot read, saying read this, they say we cannot read. Okay, so this is obviously talking about we. All right, 11. Let's read 11. A vision of all this has become for you like the words of a sealed document. If it is given to those who can read, with the command, read this. Is that also Muhammad too?
Yeah.
Carry on. Carry on.
Did you not see what
Carry, keep reading, keep reading. Do you want me to respond? Do you want me to respond? Do you want me to respond?
Do you want me to respond? I'll finish in 1 minute. This is the problem with Muslims. Okay. They will take the Bible. Okay. They think Christians don't know what the Bible says. Okay. And the context here, if you're saying that's Muhammad, then the verse before it must be Muhammad.
I'm going to respond to it.
But it's saying the verse before it is saying that this person can read.
Yeah.
Can
Muhammad read? Now the question.
Can you respond to that?
Okay, I will respond to that. When we read this Bible,
stick to what we
King James.
Stick to what we
read. No. That's that Bible. You read the translation, and it talks about a number
this
of people.
This is my Bible. Just give me the Bible.
But you read it and you used it.
Can you make the circle bigger?
Wait. Are you?
Yeah.
Are you? Do you stand by that?
Changing
that? No, I'm not saying this is a Bible. It's not my. I didn't print it. It's not my printing.
That's fine.
Okay. Do you stand by that translation or this translation?
Can you start the time?
Wait. We're going to establish.
What translation have you got?
Exactly. Exactly.
That's the problem. Exactly. So what's the problem?
So there's a difference. There's a difference in translation. Your Bibles are messed up. Your Bibles.
Okay, so there's a picture.
Do you want to use this one?
Hello, Ali Youssef.
Hello, do you want to listen?
Look at all the other translations you've got.
Look at this translation. No. We don't change the plural into singular. Show me one translation of the Quran.
Don't change the subject.
Where plural was changed to singular.
I can show you that.
I'm changing the subject.
No. Stick to this. Okay?
Same verse in this translation.
What translation is it?
And the book is delivered to him. Wait.
Cover the camera, brother, please.
Sorry. I'm reading the same
no timekeeper
in a different translation.
No timekeeper this time,
and,
yeah?
No, and the book because they opened the book.
So where's the time then?
You don't like it?
No.
You don't like it? You don't want us to continue?
No, continue, but no timekeeper.
Okay, 2 minutes, 2 minutes?
What's your problem?
We'll do.
Why did he stop?
He's just an outside.
No, he agreed. He agreed. Are you a solicitor?
He didn't say
are you a solicitor?
He told him.
He's happy. You want a dialogue.
I asked you, he said no. He said it'll be a waste of time.
You want a dialogue.
The problem.
I said okay. You want a dialogue? He said no.
I remain silent until you finish.
He said no. Okay, let me finish.
What do you want?
So
no. Wait.
Which one do you want?
Speak for 2 minutes then.
Which one?
Speak for 2 minutes.
So.
No problem.
What do you want to do? What do you want to do?
I want to read this translation and show you how different it is to that one.
So you disagree with this?
Yeah, absolutely. I don't disagree with the Christians.
Okay. But you know what's interesting? What you're saying?
Yeah.
You're saying Muhammad is in the book, but you disagree with the book.
That's what God means.
You want to talk about that?
You're confused.
That's a new topic. I'm not confused.
Do you know my view of the Bible?
Do you know my view of the Bible?
Read what you have to read.
Okay. Same verse in a different translation. There we are told it's a group of people who are told to read the book.
Keep the time.
Here we are told it's one person.
Keep the time.
Here we are told it's one person. Amazing. No, what does that mean?
What does that mean?
Are you one or ten? How many are you?
What's your point?
Are you one or ten?
Okay. Your point is, this is Muhammad. Prove
you, you believe in the Trinity. I want to surprise you.
Now it's in the Trinity. Muslims always have to run to the Trinity when they get stuck.
Godwin.
When they get stuck. Okay? So read that and show us how this Muhammad is.
Godwin is three in one. He is Godwin the Son, God. Okay.
Read Isaiah and show us.
Isaiah 29:12.
Living.
And the book is delivered to him.
Yeah.
That is not learned. Saying, read this. I pray. And he said, I am not learned. There you read, and when the book is given to them, and said to them, read this, and they say it.
Which one is right?
Wait, before we discuss it.
Woe to those who change the scriptures with their own hands.
And the Quran. Okay.
Adlan.
Listen, I have to pray now. Sorry, guys, Adlan, I have to go. This is not getting any. I'm running away.
You're not going to do it.
Shall I stay?
Stay.
It's not getting anywhere.
Verse 11. Again, where is it? 29?
No. Wait. Which translation is right? Which one is right?
Which one is right?
Read this one. Read this one. Wait.
Okay.
I said, the more you go into the hole, the deeper you will go into it.
Are you changing?
I'm telling you.
You say this Muhammad. Where is it Muhammad?
I will show you.
You say this Muhammad. Where is it Muhammad?
I will show you.
No, I want to hear Muhammad.
Okay.
Verse 11.
Verse 11. Wait.
No, wait.
Which Bible are we using? Which one? Which one are you using? Which one? Before we talk about Muhammad, which one? Which one?
You was using the same Bible.
Which one?
You was using the same Bible.
Choose one. Choose one. You choose one. No, no.
You're free.
You choose one.
You know you're intelligent. Do it properly, man.
Yes, let's do it properly. I'm asking you to choose one. Okay. You choose for him. You choose for him. Which one? Which one are we discussing? Which text are we? I'm not playing that game either.
I'm
insincere.
That's right.
Interpretation of the verse doesn't matter.
Exactly. Absolutely. The meaning changes. The meaning changes altogether. If it's one person, then it's Muhammad. If it's a group, it can't be Muhammad. And do you understand the point? Wait, my friend. Fine. But do you understand the point I'm trying to make? If one, wait, I understand that. I got the point. My point is, one text is saying, one translation is saying, it is many of them, right? In that case, it cannot be Muhammad. It's out of the question. But one text is saying it's one person, right? So I'm asking which one is right. Which one is right?
The context. Okay. I'm going to do it for the last time. Okay.
Which one is that? Godwin.
Wait. Let me respond now.
I have the Greek one as well.
I'm going to respond again.
I have the Greek text as well.
Verse 11 is saying. Read 10.
Why don't you read 10?
You just read 12. I didn't tell you to read any other verse.
Read 10. It's only one more verse.
Let me read.
It's only one more verse.
Let me just make my point. Why?
It's only one more verse.
I wouldn't.
Read 10.
Okay, I'll read 10.
Yes.
But the Lord have poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep. And close your eyes, the prophets and your
rulers. And the prophets.
Let me finish.
The prophets.
Let me finish.
Yeah. The prophets. Yeah.
And the vision of God is become unto you. Yeah, at the words of the book that is sealed, which men deliver to one of his learned, and saying, read this. So he's saying to the men, read this, I pray. And he said, I cannot, for it is sealed. Okay?
And the book is delivered to him. That is not learned. Saying, read this. I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned. When did this happen in the history of humanity? Just tell me one. When and where? Which person? Forget about prophet.
It's not Bible, man.
When did this happen?
When did it happen?
And the verse 10 says, this prophecy is about prophets. Yes, the verse 10 says it is referring to prophets. It's talking to the prophets, right? Okay. So and now you change the Bible again.
Yeah.
Now you change the Bible again.
Yes.
No, because
listen, I have to pray, man.
This is Bible.
Godwin, it's not helping you. This topic is not helping you.
Let me tell you why.
Why you change the Bible? You're going to tell me why you change the Bible?
No, because you've been. It's not in my Bible.
We have three here saying three different things. And it's not different. In wording or meaning, it is different in plurality. It makes a huge difference if it's a group of people or it's one person. Because if it's a group, Muhammad is out of the question. If it's one, then it is definitely. Obviously, there is something
here. If God says I, okay.
Godwin, is it so hard to worship God alone? Is it so hard?
Can you take over?
Different subject.
Why do you need Jesus?
Different subject.
Wait.
The person.
The next verse says that 13. So this is why we apply exegesis. Wait, I'm trying to explain.
No, we apply exegesis.
What we do, we explain what the verse means. And Christian scholars, such as Otto Kaiser. Otto Kaiser is a German Christian scholar. I read his commentary. I'm talking.
You said you're talking to me. Let's talk to me.
Verse 13, wherefore the Lord said,
for as much as this people drew near to me,
these are different people.
Hold on.
This is a different mouth. God is talking to different people.
Wait!
For
me with their mouth and with their lips do honor me, but they have removed their heart far from me, and their fear towards me is taught by the precept of men.
So here it's clearly saying, wherefore the Lord says, for as much as the people draw near to me with their mouth.
Have you read any commentaries on this passage? Oh,
no, but I've removed. Why are you ignoring my question? Why are you taking one verse?
Have you read any commentaries on this?
No, I haven't.
You haven't.
I read the Bible.
Ask me the same question. Ask me the same question.
What's your point about commentary? Ask me. You don't believe what the Bible says?
Have you read the commentary?
Yes. Yes, I have read. I have Neil Jerome's commentary on this. I have read Otto Kaiser's commentary on this. I have read Christopher North's commentary on this.
And
they're saying these two verses are dealing with two different situations.
You're misunderstanding, brother.
And the verse 10 clearly states that these are prophecies about prophets, right? So if it's a prophet, then which prophet?
But it says you can read in the book. Okay. It says you can read.
Fine. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna.
It says you can read. Fine. So could Muhammad read?
No, he can't.
Right. So why is it so?
The verse.
So okay. You need to be consistent.
Did you understand what I said? I've read commentaries.
Is this the only passage you have when a person can read? Is that the only passage you have? Is there anywhere in the Bible that says that...
It seems you're not listening to me.
No, because I've...
It seems you're completely locked.
I've listened long enough. You're completely blocked.
You're not listening to what I'm saying.
The scripture says the person can read.
Can you clarify that
point? I'm clarifying that point. Yes. I asked you, have you read commentary? You said no.
No, clarify from the Bible. The Bible's my commentary.
Okay, no. Bible does not explain itself. Bible does not explain itself.
Okay, no, listen, the Bible... Okay,
you're going to fall in a ditch now.
No,
you're going to fall in a ditch. You're making a claim now. I'm going to ask you a question from the Bible. You're going to die here. No, I'm telling you. You're not going to escape. You're not going to run anywhere.
Clarify, so you understand
the Bible from itself?
No, clarify.
Right. Stick on that.
Where's the King James?
Stick on that.
He's trying to change the subject.
I'm not changing the subject. What's the subject? You have not one time for our whole conversation given us a prophecy of Muhammad. Right? You give me that lazy commentary which clearly states that the person can read.
Okay, good.
You then say that Muhammad is illiterate and he cannot read. That's a contradictory. Okay? Do you have any other prophecies in your Quran or in your Bible? Do you have anything in your Quran or in your Bible?
They want the title.
Muhammad is prophesied.
Okay, good.
Do you have anything in the Bible?
Can I respond now? I listen to you quietly. The reason why I use this particular passage is to apply Godwin's own standard to the Bible and show him that there is a passage which is more specific than the one he used for Jesus in Isaiah 53. And there is no other man in the history of humanity who had this experience.
He's giving you an example.
An angel came to Muhammad, so he claimed. Yeah. You can reject the claim. He claimed. And he said to him, read, and he said, I am not learned. And then the Quran was given. And the Bible says, when the book is given to the one who is not learned, and it is said to him, read, he will say, I am not learned. And the friend, wait. Now coming back to you, said,
but
I did not.
I'll
give you no prophecies, one by one. Number one. Do you want to hear that? That was an example. Okay. Number one prophecy. First of all, did he do miracles? Yes, he did miracles. Number one miracle, he was traveling with over 1,000 companions, Prophet Muhammad. And this, let me finish, don't interrupt me. You ask me questions, you can jump up and down and you can reject these miracles, yeah? Fine, no problem.
So is this in the Quran?
Okay, no, it's in the Hadith.
So it's not in the Quran. Is the Hadith?
You want something
good? Hadith is better than the Bible.
Okay. Quran is the word of God, right?
Okay.
Yeah, Quran is the word of God.
Why do you have to stick to the Quran?
Did you say to me initially that I want to show me
Muhammad as a prophet from the Quran? The entire Quran is the testimony, he's a prophet.
Show us. How?
The Quran says, ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. The Quran says, Muhammad is the messenger of God and he's the last of prophets. The Quran says that. That's your one verse.
Okay.
The Quran says that.
So the Quran says
he's a prophet and as well as a messenger.
Okay.
Now Quran says that.
Okay.
Now what?
Okay. The Quran says that he's a prophet.
Yeah.
Okay. So how does that prove? So for example, if I come along, wait, hold on.
So let me say. Let me respond.
No.
Of course you're not happy with that.
No.
The Quran says. Quran says there are people whose hearts are sealed. Their eyes are closed. Their hearing is blocked. They cannot hear, they cannot see. Summun, bukmun, umyun, fahum la yarji'un. That's what the Quran says. There are people who don't want to know. They don't want to know.
You just said the Quran said he's a prophet, so he must be a prophet.
I didn't say that.
That's what you just said.
I didn't say that. You asked me where does the Quran say he's a prophet? And I gave you a verse.
No, I'm saying, I didn't ask you that, and you know I didn't ask you. Let me tell you what I did ask you, okay? You're not lying, okay? I asked you, okay, where did he prophesy? That's the question I asked you. Right, I didn't ask you if he was a prophet.
I'm giving you one now.
Let me finish, right? Okay, so I asked you a prophecy, where did he prophesy? Then you went to the Quran, I said,
thank you for the history. Thank you very much.
Now, I want to go back to my question, okay? Where is Muhammad? Can you prove Muhammad either prophesied or Muhammad did a miracle? Because you said that he did.
I'm giving the evidence.
Show us in the Quran where he did that. You haven't done it.
Why the Quran?
You haven't done it. Why the Quran?
Hadith is literature. Hadith is scripture for us. Hadith is our scripture. Did you know that?
It's not a word of Allah.
Did you know that? Hadith is our scripture.
But it's not a word of Allah.
Are you going to teach us Islam?
Correct.
No. You're going to correct me? Come correct me now. Come in front of the camera.
Don't divert here.
So be quiet. Yeah. Be quiet.
Tell your people to be quiet as well. No. Tell your friends to be quiet as well.
So, the Quran, okay, is that the word of God.
Hadith is scripture for us.
Hold on.
Do you understand that?
Okay.
Hadith is scripture for us.
Hadith is scripture, yeah.
Yes. Bukhari scripture. Bukhari scripture for us.
Okay.
Yes.
Is that scripture? Okay. Yes. So is that the word of God?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So you see on camera that the Quran is the word of God, but also the Hadith is the word.
Is a revelation. Hadith is a revelation.
You see, basically, the Hadith is a continuation of the Quran, which was God's words to Allah.
Right.
Okay, you're saying the Hadith is a continuation.
You want
of that.
Me to explain?
No. Yes, to be clear.
Yes, sir.
I need to be clear. I need to be clear. You're saying, because we know that Muhammad received the word, Allah dictated.
You throw questions at me and then answer them for me. Is that fair?
I want to be clear. I don't want to run off.
The Prophet is mentioning the Quran in his eyes.
You want to be clear?
Right. I want to be clear. So you're saying the Hadith is
the Quran is the literal word of God. I'm telling you now. The Quran is the literal word of God, word by word.
Yes.
Hadith is a complementary revelation which God inspired to Muhammad and he explained the Quran.
By living it.
By explaining it. So whatever Muhammad said about the Quran is from revelation.
Yes.
It's not a literal word of Allah. Okay, so it's not the literal word of Allah. Yes.
We reject it though.
You can reject it. So what? We don't reject it.
Let's reject your Bible. Which one do you reject?
That's what I was asking. I'll say it to you that.
Do you understand?
I do understand what you're saying.
Thank you.
Now, what I want you to give me is what you can say. For example, I speak to Sunnis and Shiites and different denominations of Islam, and they disagree. Okay?
What? What is he talking about?
There's a fight. Don't worry about it.
Oh, okay. So, they disagree on whether we should use the Hadith or not. Some people don't believe the Hadith is offensive.
Wait. So you want to stick to your question or not?
Or you want to jump around the ring? Hold on.
Sting like a butterfly.
I want you to fly like a bee.
Is that what you want to do? You want to sting me and run away? Sting me and run away? You want to answer?
Adnan, stay focused.
You're telling me stay focused? You're telling me stay focused? So let's talk about prophecies. You want to know? Prophecies and miracles. Miracles. Now you're limiting it, the Quran.
We've been here for how long?
Okay, so you want it from the Quran?
I want it from the word of God.
I said, okay, no problem. My time. I was going to give you prophecies.
In the Quran.
You don't like the Hadith.
In the Quran.
Oh, no, why not? Why not Hadith? Why
you've
not?
Got nothing in the Quran.
Why not?
So why'd you believe?
Why not Hadith, though? Why not Hadith?
Brother,
I believe in the Quran. I'll give you prophecies from the Quran. Okay,
brother,
I will, right now. But why not Hadith?
Do it.
Why not Hadith? I'm showing the people the kind of people you are. I'm showing the world the kind of people you are.
Listen, we need to go and pray. You need
the Quran.
Chapter
24.
Read it. Don't run.
Chapter 24.
He's going to run, man.
he's going to run.
Let him wear it.
A prophecy and show us how it came to pass.
Chapter 24 of the Quran. Yes.
Show us how
it came to pass. Yes. Verse 55. I know it by heart, don't worry. Verse 55. I'm going to read it in Arabic. The original. No translation. No translation.
I speak English.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa'adallahu alladhina amanu minkum wa'amilu s-salihat la yastakhlifannahum fil ard kama istakhlafa alladhina min qablihim. Right? It is a promise of Allah to those who believe among you that the succession in the land will be given to you. You will over la yastakhlifannahum fil ard literally means that you will be given power in the earth.
So what happened after?
On the planet earth. Within a century of this revelation, the Muslims were governing from northern China to southern France. The largest chunk of land ever governed by any human group on the planet.
How did he know?
And this is, wait, I'm not finished. I'm not finished. Takbir!
Explain now, explain.
Wait. You're smiling now. No problem. No problem. Just like, wait. Just because I'm not saying things doesn't mean they don't exist. I'm trying to establish my case so that people can see how confused you are about your own sources. You are wrong about David. You are wrong about prophecies in the Quran. It's there. It's there. And it's very specific. And I have to go and
pray. You're going to run. You're going to say that.
I'm going to run now.
See, summarize. Godwin, summarize. To the camera. You got 2 minutes.
What verse?
Verse 55. Why you keep jumping, man?
24:55.
Godwin.
24:55.
No. Summarize. Godwin, 3 minutes and
Allah
it's got 3 minutes.
Allah has promised. And read loud. Read loud.
Summarize. 3 minutes.
Allah has
three
promised.
3 minutes for
Godwin, one second.
Wait.
Let me speak because we're going to go. You have to summarize. You've got 3 minutes.
Allah has promised. No, I'm not going to.
Allah has promised. And he fulfilled the
Allah has promised to those among you who believe and work righteous deeds that he will of a surety grant them in the land inheritance as he granted it to those. That's in brackets.
Yeah, no problem. That's what it means. In Arabic, it means that.
As he granted it to those before them, but he will establish an authority, their religion.
Their religion.
The one which he has chosen for them, and that he will change after the fear in which they too one of security and peace. They will worship me. And not to associate thought with me. If any do reject faith after this, they are rebellious and wicked. Okay. So you're saying this.
Did you understand the verse? Okay.
So
what is he saying?
He's saying that he's promising those who do good deeds, that they will gain authority.
Authority in the land.
In the land.
In the land. Is that specific enough?
Right. Okay.
Is that a specific prophecy?
Wait.
I'm trying to understand. Are you a solicitor?
Yes.
So be quiet. Is that specific enough? Is that specific enough?
You deceive me.
Wait. Is that specific enough?
I know he said, but it's not prophecy. Let me explain.
It's not a prophecy.
Let me explain.
It says Allah has promised you.
Right.
Allah has promised you. You do this, and you will get this. And within a century, they did that and they got that.
Right. Okay.
Do you understand?
Two things you have to do.
1 minute.
1 minute left, and I have to go to pray.
Yeah, you have to show us.
My phone.
I have to show you what you really want to see. And I cannot show you what you really want to see. Because I see what you want to see. And I cannot see what you want to see. Hence, I cannot show you what you want to see.
He's coming back.
Is it getting anywhere with this guy?
Let me explain. I want you to say something.
Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters.
Are you not going to let me talk?
Give me the chance.
You need to first show us. Yeah.
You asked me for a prophecy in the Quran.
There it is.
Muhammad. Now, ready. Say the Shahada. Say the Shahada.
Adnan, you're deceiving.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Thank you for listening. It's very clear. Godwin came to us, asked a question. What makes Muhammad a prophet? Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I asked him to clarify as to what a prophet means to him. He was confused about it. Clearly, he made a mistake, a major mistake in the Bible. I asked him, is David a prophet? He said, no, David is not a prophet. And then he asked us, show him where David is a prophet. He was shown to be incorrect. He made an error. I'm trying to summarize. And then we went on to discuss what is a prophet. He said a prophet is someone who prophesies and who had miracles. Then I asked him to explain what is a prophecy and what is a miracle. And then when, subhanAllah, as you all saw, we had a long discussion on that without any firm conclusion. And then he asked me to give me a prophecy. I gave him a prophecy, was going to give him a prophecy of hadith. He said, no hadith, no hadith, no hadith. He said, Quran. Then I gave him a prophecy from the Quran, and he's still finding it difficult to believe. So where do we go? Thank you. Thank you for your time, God bless.